We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Okay, now we will see 2 examples, then you will understand how the rules are applied here. Okay, the first example is like that. The following are the angles observed at a triangular transverse along with their probable error. Determine the correct values of the angles. Okay, it is given that triangular traverse, and what is given, its error is also given. Which law we can apply? We can apply the error formula, that is the law 2. Okay, law distribution rule 2 we can apply. Okay, so what are the things given? All the 3 angles plus its error. This portion is its error. Okay, so it's a triangular traverse, then obviously angle 3 angles should be equal to 180 degree. Here what is given? It is given as A plus B plus C. You can add it and find out. It is coming to 179, 59 minute, 50 second. So discrepancy, okay, that means the actual 180 degree minus what actually in here we have got. Okay, that means 10 second is discrepancy is there. We have to adjust this correction. Then each angle should be increased so that error 10 second is to be distributed proportionally to the square of the probable error, that is application of rule 2. Okay, how this is applied here? See, let C1, C2, C3 are the corrections applied to angle A, angle B and angle C. So C1 is to C2 is to C3. Okay, according to that rule, what is given? That is directly proportional to the square of the errors. Errors is given here. Okay, so we have 2 square, 4 square, 5 square. It is given in the question. What is another thing we know? All the correction, that is C1 plus C2 plus 3 is equal to this discrepancy. Okay, that is 10 second. Now we will see what is the condition. C1 is to C2 is to C3. We know that is 4. Okay, we are squaring that 4, 16, 25. Okay, equate this portion C1, C2, C2, C3. Equate it and find in terms of C1. Normal, simple, mathematical, this thing. Okay, then add it and find out the value of C1, C2 and C3. Now C1 plus C2, C3, add, check it whether it is coming to 10 seconds. Okay, so the corrected angles are the actual given one plus C1, second one given in the question plus C2. Okay, this is C1, C2, C3. So we got all the final A, B and C. The final check, you can check it whether it is coming, the addition exactly 180 is coming or not. Okay. Now the second question is like that. Adjust the following angles closing the horizon. Okay, here what is given? Instead of the error, it is given the weight. Okay, in this case 3 angles, and this is weight given. The previous question error is given, so we can apply the rule 1. Okay, rule 1 is inversely proportional to the weight. Okay, inversely proportional to the weight. Okay, here it is given 4 sides. Okay, 4 sides are there, so it means it is a quadrilateral, so the angle should be 360 degree. But what is given here? Add all the sides and find out how much the degrees are coming. That is 360 degree, 0 minute, 0 8 second. Okay, this much is extra. So correction should be applied. Okay, 8 second error will be distributed to the angles in an inversely proportional to the weight. Okay, weight of their angles. So same procedure, C1, C2, C3, C4 are the corrections to be applied for A, B, C, D. C1 is to C2 is to C3 is equal to 1 by 2. That is inversely proportional to the weight. Weights are given in the question. Okay. So another thing that we know is the sum of all the corrections is equal to 8 second. So same thing, okay, take the first portion, second portion, third portion, equate it and find out the values of C1, C2, C3 and the C4, okay. Then the corrected angles, this is given in the question, minus, okay. Why we are minusing? Because it was extra, okay. So 8 second was extra, we have to minus it and adjust it. This is C1, C2, C3 and C4. This is the final angles, okay. As a check, you can add it and prove that it is exactly coming to 360 degree, okay. And one more question from that part, that is find the most probable value of angle A. This question is a most probable value calculation from the following observation equation. A is given, 3A is given, okay. What we have to find out? We have to find out the most probable value of this angle A, okay. So you can note down, this is our first equation, this is second equation, okay. The first normal equation we have to find out. Normal equation A is formed under, see this condition, multiply the first equation by 2, that means equation into weight, okay. See the equation is like that. A, what is the constant here? 1. What is the weight given in this question? Its weight is 2 and its weight is 3. So the constant value, that is A, that is 1 into this weight, okay. So 1 into 2. And second equation by 9, how you got this 9? Because this portion is a 3 into its weight is 3, okay. So the multiplying the second equation by 9 and multiplying the first equation by 2, okay. So we are multiplying our first and second equation. 2a is equal to 2 into this much, 9 into 3a is this much. So 2a is 60 degree 57 minute 20 second and 27a is equal to this much, okay. Add these two and find out the value of A. This is the most probable value of A, okay. This is a simple question, but it is asked in a one GTU question, okay. This is the formation of normal equations, okay. There are many questions coming under this this portion, okay. This same sample, okay. You can do at least one or two and understand this very normal, simple mathematical calculation. No big equation to by heart, okay. So understand this method and you can able to do it easily, okay. This is the simplest chapter, okay. You can easily get more marks from this chapter also. Now students, another pattern of question is like that, formation of normal equation. One we have already seen in the last portion, and this is like this: find the most probable of value of angles ABC of the triangles ABC from the following observation equations. Angle A is given, B is given, C is given, okay. How to start the solution? It's a triangular traverse, okay. So the sum of angles is like the 180 degree. This condition is, this equation is observed by writing the third observation equation involving C in terms of A and B is selected in independent quantities, okay. So this we have to make independent observation equations for A and B separately, okay. So A is given, B is given. What we have to find? We have to make a normal equation for what a first and a normal equation for b second. Okay, how to find out normal equation for a? That is 180 minus a plus b is equal to c. That is our condition. So out of that, a plus b is equal to 180 minus c. Okay. 180 minus c, so we are getting a plus b value as this much. Now we can find the normal equation for a. A is known and a plus b is known. Okay, so as write a mathematical equations. Okay, you can just multiply 2a plus b is equal to this much. Similarly for b also you calculate b is this much, a plus b is this much, so a plus 2b is equal to this much angle. So you got two equation, 2a plus b is this much, a plus 2b is equal to this much. Okay, how to, you can multiply this by 2. Okay, so simple mathematically how to find out the unknown things. Okay, a and b, so 3b, so you are getting b. Put this value in any of these equations and find out a also. Now what is the condition? Angle c is equal to 180 minus a plus b, so 180 minus a plus b. How much is a plus b? So you can add these two a plus b values and find out c. Okay, so a plus b is equal to 180, that is the condition. We got a from this here, a here, b here and c here. Okay, as a check you can cross check all the add the values and find out 180. What is the procedure? I will tell you one more thing. A was given, B was given and C given. We are not taking the C value right now. We are taking A, B. What is C? 180 minus A plus B. Out from A plus B is equal to 180 minus C. We are finding out A plus B value. Okay. Here we are using that C value. Okay. C we are using. So, we can form the nominal equation for A and B. That is, A is equal to, we know already from here, A is this much and A plus B is this much. So, multiplying this, adding this one, 2A plus B is equal to this much. Similarly, for B also, B we know, A plus B we know. From these two equations, we are finding out A and B first. Then we will go and find out C value. Okay, so adding all the values, we are proving that the sum of angles is equal to 180 degree. Now, this is another question. This is a corrections. We have to add the corrections and find out this one. Okay, this is also one of a GTO questions. Okay. Determine the most probable value of angle of a triangular PQR from the given data. Use the method of correlates. Okay, if it is given the method of correlates, then you have to use it. It's not corrections. Okay, this is correlation method. Okay, what is given? Angle is given, its weight is given. Three angles and three weights. Okay. Solution, same thing, PQR is equal to 180. Here how much it is coming, add all these things plus corrections, that is C1, C2 and C3. Okay. Now from the equation 1 and 2, what is the correction it is coming? It's a minute correction, we have to apply 6 degree. Okay. 6 minute, a second. Okay. The least square equation is given as least square. This is W1 C1 square plus W2 C2 square plus W3 C3 square is equal to minimum. That is the least square equation. Partially we are differentiating, some maths part is coming here. Okay, it is very similar similar or same question. Okay, so you can study like this itself. Okay, partial differentiation equation of 3 and 4, differentiating del C1, differentiation of C2 is equal to 0. Similarly differentiating the second one also. Okay, so we are in the this equation we are multiplying it with the minus lambda 1, okay. So it is coming like this, okay. And we are adding 6 and 7 now. So delta C1 is common. So we are adding all this and then equating the coefficient, okay. Equating the coefficient to 0. We are finding out C1, C2 and C3. Three corrections we are find out, okay. So in terms of this one and this one is a 6. Is equal to 6 a second. So we are taking common things, okay, adding and find out the value of lambda 1, that is 6 second. Lambda 1 is coming to 3.27 second, okay. So C1, apply the equation and find out C1, C2 and the C3, okay. Now what we'll do, hence the correction angles are the given question, it is given in the question, plus C1, okay, this is how much, plus C2 plus C3, okay, these all are the after the corrections, the angles are coming like this, and as a check, you can add PQR is equal to 180 degree, okay, exactly, in the previous case, it was not 180 degree, easily we have done all this calculation, it was 179, 59 minute, 54 second, only 6 second was less. So we are adjusted with the correction method, okay, correlation method, okay. So always note that a triangular traverse is given means we have to add three sides and 180 degree. So quadrilateral four sides are given, add all the sides and the check is 360 degree, okay. So with this portion, I think we have with this we have come to the end of this chapter, theory of errors, okay. For me, I think this is the easiest chapter compared to the all other chapters, okay, because there here no need to by heart any big formula, or we have to no need of proving or anything, or a derivation is not there, it's only for adjustment of errors, okay. So it's like a maths, okay. If you are solving two equations and finding out the value of A, B or C, okay. So students, that's the end of our old lecture series, okay. All the best for your exams. Kindly please don't waste your time, do at least whatever I have teach you, okay. You can just do examples on a daily basis, okay. I'm telling you again and again that if you have any doubt, mail me or contact me, okay. I will there to help you anytime, okay. All the best students, thank you so much.